There are several different ways that you can fine-tune the shadows and highlights in your photographs in order to really add some contrast to bring out the subject and just give a lot more depth to your photos. So today I'll show you three different ways you can do that and tell you which one is my favorite.
I think that this is an excellent lens.
Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Emma and professionally I'm a software developer, but my free time I love landscape photography and making related videos here on YouTube. Today I want to take a look at a couple of editing techniques you can do for brightening highlights and darkening shadows, just to give a little bit more life to your photos. So I'm going to do that looking at this photo that I took in the video of a photo shoot that I did last week. And so if you enjoyed landscape photography, definitely just head over there and check that video out as well. Here is the photo that I have for you today. This was a very unique phenomena, so that was why I took this photo of it. It's not necessarily your most traditional beautiful landscape photo, but all of the leaves as they were washing down the stream, at some point, you know, one of them had hit a rock and then another one had washed up and hit it and so forth. And they had all piled up like this, one after another, kind of on end in this big little like leaf pile here. And I just thought that was pretty cool and shot a photo of it. And then I've done a little bit of editing to it already in the HSL adjustment just to bring out some of those colors. So I've saturated a little bit, saturated the reds and adjusted their hue a little. Same thing for the yellows, made them a little bit more red actually, just to really bring out those fall tones in those leaves. So what I want to do now is I want to enhance some of the highlights in the water here. There's kind of this splashing water. It was a long exposure, and where the water was splashing a little bit and flowing, there's some highlights there. And I want to enhance those so that they kind of surround the leaves a little. There's actually several different ways that I could do this. One is that I could add a contrast layer. And if I just pulled up the contrast, that's going to kind of brighten the highlights a little bit and darken the shadows. The problem that I have with this is that I just don't have that much control over how much the highlights get brightened and the shadows get darkened. It's pretty much, you know, a blanket control in one slider. So that just doesn't give me enough control. Second thing that I could do is I could use the dodge and burn tool. So if I take the dodge tool, that one will brighten the highlights. You can select which tonal range actually you want it to brighten. So you could also be brightening your shadows or your midtones. So you get a lot of power there. But I could take that and brighten the highlights like this, and just paint on any place where I would like for the highlights to be brighter. Same thing, then I could take the burn tool and I could paint on any place where I would like the shadows to be a little bit darker. The thing that I don't really like about this is it's what's called a destructive edit. Now, I could undo it, but I can't just uncheck an adjustment layer here like I can with my other edits. I can't go back and adjust how much I have made these adjustments to the highlights and shadows. If I decide later on, maybe I brighten them too much or I want to brighten them more, there's no way for me to go back and do that. So I'm going to go back in my edit history here. There's this little history tab, and I'm just going to go back to before I made those tool adjustments. And I'm going to show you the way that I prefer to do this. It's kind of similar in a way because I'm going to brush on the adjustments, but I'm going to have the ability to go back and edit them later because I'm going to use a shadow highlight layer. And so I'll make one of those, and I can actually just go ahead and make the adjustment on it as well. So I'm going to really kind of blow the highlights, darken the shadows up a little bit. But obviously I don't want to apply this on the entire image, so I will invert it by pushing Command I, and then I will get my brush tool, just make it nice and soft by turning the hardness all the way down, and select the white color to brush the layer back on. And now I can go through and I can just brush on different areas. I'm actually adjusting the shadows and the highlights all in one go because I put this on the same layer. Typically, that's actually fine. I don't usually need multiple layers, but you could do them on different layers if you needed to in order to separate out those adjustments. And I can just brush this onto different areas here to bring out the highlights, to deepen the shadows in the water here around this. And now unchecked, this is what it looked like before. It was a little bit flatter. Checking it adds a lot of contrast in the area around the leaves, just adds a little bit more depth to this photograph. So hopefully that helps you to see several different ways that you can add some contrast and depth to your photos, whether with just a straightforward contrast adjustment, a little bit more power in those dodge and burn tools, which I do use sometimes, or with the shadow and highlight adjustment, which is kind of my preferred option because it gives me more control to brighten and darken different areas of the photo while still having the ability to go back and edit it later. So that is going to be all for this video. It's just a little bit shorter of a video. I've actually filmed 4 videos already this week. This is my 5th one that I'm recording, kind of batch filming for in the next few weeks as I'm getting ready to move. There may still be some times in there where I do miss a video, and I apologize for that, but I've filmed a lot in advance, and so hopefully I'll be able to keep up as much as possible with getting videos out for you guys. Anyway, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to hit the like button on your way out and to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss more videos that I'm really excited to share with you in the future. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.